Okay, now we have already discussed the database and the database management systems, and we learned the advantage and disadvantage of database management system. And now let's look into what a database management system actually contains. So a database contains following data. One is the user data and metadata, and we also have the indexes, and we have application metadata. So we are going to go into each of them in detail. So the user data will be quite simple. That will be the data users work with directly by entering, updating, and viewing. That will be the actual data, all the numbers, all the information we need to record. And those information will generally stored in tables or tabulars with some relationships between tables. This is exactly how we have the name of relational database. And each table will have one or more columns, and a set of columns forms a database record. Or each table will be built up with columns and rows. And those columns will be a database structure for you to record the value. When you add one record, it will be a row of the table, and the table will be a database record. And the metadata is data about data. Basically, it is how to describe the data stored in terms of the name and the columns name, the data type, the length, the primary key, all the structure of your data will be called metadata, and that will be saved in our database as well. And it will be saved in system tables or system catalogs and may not be seen by you directly. Only the user has high level of authority will be able to modify and change it. Indexes. So when we do insert, when we do delete and update, a lot of times we may have to move the information around in our database. So if the file or if the information is large, then the move for the piece of information is actually very inefficient. So in order to do those things quickly and efficiently, we have an index, which is we have a very short amount of bytes to represent those large piece of information. So instead of a document, instead of an article or paper, we may just use some digits of numbers to represent them. So rather than move those articles around, we just need to move those indexes around so that we can do the operations much, much more quickly. It can accelerate our storing, our sorting, our searching significantly. And indexes will be built either manually or automatically, and it will allow the database to access a record without having to search through the entire table, but by some very smart way and jump into that particular position quickly. And so when we do the updates of our data, we have to update the index as well. That is why we need this extra information. And again, because of the advantage of using index is very large, so it overweights this disadvantage of extra step, extra memory, extra storage. The application's metadata is about the facilities, such as the forms that enable the user to enter data easier, and the reports that enable the users to see a summary of your data easier, and the queries and some other application components. So this kind of facilities will be saved in application metadata. And again, you will be accessing those kind of data through the database development programs, such as Access. So you can look at the Documenter tool in Microsoft Access. It will show the metadata for the queries, for the forms, for the reports, all over all in your database.